In this video, I plan to show you how to take a pneumatic air cylinder, a manual control valve like this joystick, or even this foot pedal, a few fittings, some tubing, and your own scary head, creature, or device, and add it to your prop collection. Now, I selected the largest spring return air cylinder that we carry here at Automation Direct. It's part number A12060SP. This one only requires air to be applied to one side of the cylinder. When the air pressure is released, the cylinder returns back to its original position. Now I'm using a registered remake prop that I bought years ago and put at the end of the air cylinder. Now, if you noticed, most all air cylinders will be threaded on the end, so it's up to you how your creature is connected. Next, I want to plumb the air from my joystick to the air cylinder. As you can see on this joystick, it has five openings or ports. They're labeled A, B, R, P, and S. A and B are feed out. P is our supply in, while R and S are exhaust ports out. We only need one supply and one exhaust. So if we don't plumb it correctly, the air will fill the cylinder, hold pressure. So we need to make sure that when the joystick returns home, the pressure is released or exhausted. On the exhaust ports, you should use a silencer like this one to reduce noise and keep contaminants out of the valve. Now, it's suggested to use a silencer on the exhaust ports and to plug all unused ports. Now, this will keep dirt and trash out and ensure that your equipment will last for a long time. As far as fittings and tubing, you'll need to check the thread sizes of the air cylinder and the control valves that you selected and match them. There are several options on the hose sizes, but I chose to use a quarter inch since it's pretty standard. Now I simply install all the fittings in the correct ports, cut my tubing to the desired length, and connect them all. As you can see, the fittings I used on the cylinder side is different than the ones that I used on the control valve. Here I have an adjustable fitting that allows for control of airflow at the cylinder itself. This allows for more control of the extend speed. Now I just need to plumb my air supply. And here, we're using a small compressor that I purchased at a home supply store. Now, these can be found as little as $50 if you shop around. Now, I only want to use enough air pressure to move the cylinder out in a rapid, but not too fast of a motion. If you use too much air pressure, you'll prematurely wear out your parts. Okay, so I'm set. As you can see, it's all plumbed and sort of set up as a temporary prop. Now, you can imagine this head popping out of a wall or a fake body cavity. The person controlling it can be isolated or hidden with this joystick, so it'll work like this. Now, all of the products that we've used in this system are products that Automation Direct sells, with the exception of our air compressor. So keep this in mind for all of your automation needs, and thanks for watching. And I hope you follow me through the next two videos to see how this prop progresses to a fully automated system.